Hello, Tamers and Digi-destined, and welcome back to Digimobs into the digital world. So last time, we were working on this little thing right here. Ancient debris. Got up to 7 before I decided I needed to come work on a few other things. So we're just going to smelt those up real quick. And while those are smelting, I want to show what I've actually been working on. I decided to expand the villager hut. I don't think this showed off in the last video. I really don't think it did. But the expansion has moved a few people around. And yeah, we have now got, we're going to be starting a contingent plan of, this is a lot of iron. We're already up to 47 iron. And I did start a weaponsmith, which I don't have near enough for. And I do have 16 ender pearls now. Towards the end goal. Ah, yes, he can finally take iron trades. Perfect. He's already a master cleric. And yeah, I still do have one trader left over. Because I am going to be putting in another enchantment. I still need a few enchantments before I think I'm prepared fully. Well, we've got the 7 netherite scrap. It looks like the crafting matrices just said we can now make this a netherite ingot. So we're going to do the first thing that, one of the first things we made. No, we're not. We don't have fortune on this yet. But the Silk Touch Axe, on the other hand. It is now a netherite axe. And, oh, that looks beautiful. Actually, we're going to leave the smithing table right there. We don't have one in the house. Of course, we will need more going forward on the netherite scrap. But I've also remembered I was working on trying to find out about this odd type of crops that seems to be, that we haven't found yet. And those odd types of crops might help in heading towards an end goal. So instead of, the main thing I'm going to do today is I'm going to try to collapse the Silk Touch books for the Silk Touch pickaxe. I have 17 levels. I think I can do it. As long as I mix properly. Alright, so we'll start with efficiency and unbreaking, then silk touch with mending, then which way is cheaper? Because sometimes one book into the other is cheaper. Alright, so this book into this book is cheaper. 8 levels, and now we have an enchanted book that has efficiency 5, unbreaking 3, silk touch, and mending. So now we have the silk touch pickaxe ready. Red Coralmon. And these are for an enchanted hoe, but again, I don't have fortune yet, which is the only other thing I would put on a hoe. I have looting, mending, and I'm breaking for the sword when I get towards it, but I do kind of need more. And for that, we're going to need paper trades to see if these two have any other good books. Because this guy, I believe, is already... Yep, he's already mastered. So these two are the new... Let's find out what they got. But we can always get more money the easy way. Which I probably will work on getting more money through stick trades. Oh yeah, I should drop off these iron axes. Oh right, I don't know. No, I know why I came over here. Okay, so I do have paper, but just not... Looks like all the crops are also ready to be brought in, but at this point I'm only particularly looking for the paper. So it's going to be quite easy to... I do think I need to expand this farm. Or make it automated. The automation's not too different than the bamboo farm. Although the bamboo farm, I probably should have made a bit shorter on the automation. Because then bamboo would actually be going a lot faster. But I also just didn't want to make it that close to the house either. Alright, there we go. Two stacks plus an extra 3 stack of paper. Should be fine. Alright, we'll go for the efficiency 5 guy, because he's been sitting here for a while. Let's see what you got next. Respiration 3. I believe that's something... Yeah, the helmet doesn't have Respiration 3 yet. Because there's the stuff for the boots right there. There's the chest piece. Or this would be the legs, the chest piece, and then this would be the helmet, which the helmet requires Respiration 3. 4 books for 1 emerald. I'm really going to have to... Oh, yeah. Those 2 spaces are going to be for probably more librarians. Alright, so... Let me go ahead and switch up this guy's thing. Efficiency 5. Buys paper. And he's now got... respiration 3. Now the only issue I'm gonna see is currently I'm not getting the I'm not maximizing trades. In order to maximize trades, got an idea, but I'm not gonna like it too much. In order to maximize trades, I need to go into the Nether. Because right now I'm maximizing the iron with this. I'm gonna maximize crop output with this. Actually, I need a different crop right there. Let me just grab a carrot real quick. Wait. That's not even a full-grown villager. It can be considered in this? That's funny. Alright, you know what? I'll see if it allows it for, oh, I think I need the seeds for the rest of these. So I'll have to go back to the base. But the way I'm thinking about it now, we're going to need quite a few things still to go towards the end game. Yes, I know a lot of people still say, well, you could just run the armor you're wearing currently, the iron, the gold with some gold if you're going through the Nether. No. If I'm going against something potentially in the end, I want good, really good armor. Plus, I want feather falling on those boots still. So, I think I already got feather falling, but there's a lot more I can get. There it is. Okay, so I need, let's grab a melon seed, a pumpkin seed, a beetroot seed, and a wheat seed. And we'll take him over there. The Digimon themselves have been mainly, I have brought out my Digimon every once in a while, but I haven't really been working on leveling them, as I'm not sure if there's going to be anything there that's going to be a problem to them. Actually, I could just go ahead and plant those three seeds. If it'll let me. Okay, pumpkin doesn't work. Melon doesn't work. Beetroot should work. There we go. I wonder if it counts for this. Yeah, that's even worse. If that counts, that makes this incubator useless. Especially if both of these count, because that's all I could just use child villagers for. Alright, so melon seeds and pumpkin seeds are worthless. I I do have two more spots. I'll probably put in another potato, another carrot. But I'm still lacking on one of the necessary things to make this exceedingly good. And that is being able to utilize price differences. Whether it be a hero of the village, or in the biggest case, changing them into zombies and then changing them back. Now, the major thing I need at that point is potions. But I haven't even gone and gotten the stuff that I need for. I haven't even gotten the things I need for. Go ahead and drop this, this. Keep one antique atlas on me. An extra stack of baked potatoes. Extra iron sword and a boat. And we'll grab a bunch of those iron. I'll grab four iron axes. Grab a shield. Do I have any? Blackstone's part of some of my projects, so. Oh. Ah, here we go. There's my building blocks for the Nether. Nether wart. We are going to be heading into the Nether. Again, mainly this time for one big thing. And that thing is going to be what we need for crafting potions, which seems to be a blaze rod and blaze powders. So, see you there. You can never, ever get used to that. All right. So we have directions we can look. Seems there's something over here to this direction. And that is one of the two directions that I've gone pretty good distance in. And considering that one has two of those structures on the books, I'm going to bet that that is the possibility that those are the structures I'm looking for. Of course, we don't want to go over lava a lot. Throw the axe in there, but I'm gonna keep this mushroom in my main hand. 'Cause I think this mushroom wards off certain hog-like creatures. of course those things would still hit me. I almost feel like I should have just went from the above section and then just mined down. Yeah, because it looks like there is a very vast lava-like ocean in front of us. I'm curious. Those creatures in the lava. If I could figure out a way to ride them, maybe. I've got an idea. I just need to get back to the portal and go back to base. Okay, we found the section I decimated. Well, wait, if we found the section I decimated, then that means the entrance is over there. Which would lead all the way back up to there. Okay. Ah, and there's a few of those creatures around here. Perfect. Alright, we're gonna move a few of these mushrooms with us. Get your weaknesses, boyos. that there so it can't get in. All right. And back up here. How did we come up over there? We left over there. Huh? What? That's actually a thing. How did we come up over there? Okay. I'm not going to question that. I really should, but I'm not going to. Yeah. Dimensional travel still sucks. Alright. So, if those lava rider things are similar to a horse, if we've got a saddle, we do. But how to get them close to us? They don't seem to have any favorite type of food. A fishing rod, maybe? Best option, worst option. I mean, worst option, I lose all this gear and all this food, and I'll have to re-earn everything I've got, but at least it's not any of my diamond stuff. Keep it up, jeebus. Alrighty. We're back in the Nether. Alright. No, it seems those hogs are... Wait, that thing's already got a saddle on it. I walked away. There's one over here. Didn't even need... Wait, it's not moving. Oh, do I need something to lead it? Maybe it does have a favorite food. Perhaps it's one of these mushrooms. This one? And we'll grab one of these as well. Alright, where's the one that... Alright, there's the one I put a saddle on. Oh, here it is. Maybe, I hope this is it. Aha! Okay, so we need to go this way with it. We're gonna have to ride this way for a second. I hope we can find a way around. Okay. I just phased partially through that. Alrighty. This is a bit... This is a nicer lava travel. Alrighty. Really wish I could have grabbed the one that already had a saddle on it, though. Wouldn't have had to use my saddle. Wonder how I get this saddle back. Well, it seems it doesn't have an inventory. Ooh. Ruined portal. All right. It's a bit slow, but it's a bit slower than my own 2 feet, but hey, can't complain when you got a free ride and you don't have to press the W key to go through the digital world. Even Gray Force I had to control when he gave me a lift. Plus, for as slow as it is, it's a lot faster than my own walking. The structure I see should be up ahead here somewhere. Looks like there's lava that leads right up to it. But I have to go a bit more north to get to it. Alright. Come on. Let's see what you got for me. I don't see anything special here. Is it above me further? Oh, it seems the little guy doesn't like not being in lava. Well, I did. Oh. I did get my saddle back from that, so. Wait, is this? We're right underneath it. This might be it. The only problem I see is, well, at first, I probably didn't have enough blocks to scale it. Now I probably, well, I've got to figure out a way to scale it from the outside too, without using a pickaxe, because I didn't mine into it, or I can't mine into it. All right, seems. Perfect. A terrible fortress. So this is where we're going to find Blazes at. Alrighty, we'll make a small base camp down here towards the exit. Mainly out of Nether wart blocks and shroom lights. And we'll use some of the crimson to make a crafting table and a set of doors. That way, nothing can get in on this side, and nothing can get in on this side. There! We've made a little home base for us until we can find everything we need. So, that is where I'll call it. Thank you everyone so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you all next time we go digital. Stay digital, y'all.